Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We magnify your holy name. For you are God. You do great things. You do mighty things. And there is none like unto thee. This morning, we look up to you for grace and for glory, even as we break words, your word, Lord. We ask that your spirit will teach us all things. Teach us even the deep things of the word. And let your glory shine and reign through us, O Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Beloved, we just want to give God praise for you. This morning, we're going to be talking on what is titled, Look in the Mirror. Look in the Mirror. And our text is going to be taken from 1 John chapter 2, 15 to 17. 1 John chapter 2, 15 to 17. We'll be reading the NIV. It says, do not love the world or anything in the world. If anyone loves the world, love for the Father is not in them. For everything in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, comes not from the Father, but from the world. The world and its desires pass away, but whoever does the will of God live forever. Amen. Praise the Lord. Whoever does the will of God lives forever. Hallelujah. Look in the mirror. See, beloved, when we look in the mirrors, when we wake up in the morning or whenever in our life, we see a reflection of the persons that we are. So if we look in that mirror and there is a need to shave, there is a need to maybe comb our hair, there is a need to do A or B, or our clothes look ruffled, we want to do something about it. Now, if you go to 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 18, 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 18, scripture says, and we all who with unveiled faces contemplate the Lord's glory have been transformed into his image with ever increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit. Now, if you go to the book of Job chapter 32 and verse 8, Job chapter 32 and verse 8, scripture says, but there is a spirit in man, and the inspiration of the Almighty giveth them understanding. So the reflection of the Spirit of God upon our life is such that we are able to get inspiration from God to continue to lead the lives that God has called us to live out of the obscurity that we have found ourselves in, the light of God's word. So beloved, when we talk about looking in the mirror, the question today is, what do you see? The scriptural reading we read in 1 John chapter 2 asked a simple, said three things about the word. So do you see the word or do you see God? Do you see God the Father or do you see the word? We have talked about what happens to us when we increasingly allow the image of God to be reflected in us, all right? Now, if you see the word, three things are common. When you look in the mirror of your life, three things you would see if you are living in worldliness, in the world. The first is the lust of the flesh. That's what First John chapter 2, 15 to 17 talks about, lust of the flesh. Lust of the flesh looks at the craving for physical pleasure. What are the things that you crave for? What are those things that you do that are not of God? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now, we need to understand that the devil wants us to just begin to question what God says about sin. So what are the things you crave for? Are they of God or they are not of God? The second is the lust of the eyes. Hallelujah. Now you see, the greatest trick that the devil has is that when we start questioning God's commandment, what the devil immediately does, once he jumps in, what does he do? He tries to refocus us away from what God has said onto the things of the world. It's what happened to Adam and Eve. Yes, immediately they started questioning. Immediately they bought into the lies of the serpent. Oh, did God say? He did not say it. He asked them, did God say? Now, once that starts happening, your eyes are tuned away from what God wants. They are tuned to the lust of the eyes. You begin to see the things that are luring, the things that call you and tend you, hallelujah, from what God says. You begin to see that what the devil is saying, what the world is offering, really looks good. So long before you know it, you become involved in corrupt practices. You are stealing from others. You begin to do depraved things because you have started questioning. Ah, man will not live by bread alone now. Praise the Lord. Ah, man, why will I always eat only this? Hallelujah. And the last is the pride of life. The pride of life. And the pride of life is boasting about what we have or do. It's one of the greatest trapping of our world for us to get focused on keeping up with everyone else. We want to have what they have. We want to do whatever it is necessary to get it. Once we are in this kind of state of mind, oh, my dear friend, you are already dealing with the pride of life. You are walking in that stead. So, are you caught up in the pride of life, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh? If you are, then you are living in the mirror of the world. That's what you see. Hallelujah. But if you are walking with the Father, if you go to 1 John 3:7-10, 1 John 3:7-10, scripture says, dear friends, do not let anyone lead you astray. If you read down that scripture, it talks about three key things that are the characteristics of the child of God. One of them is that you don't continue sin. He said the reason the Son of God appeared was to destroy the devil's work. He said no one who is born of God will continue to sin. So it means that you must understand that one of the things that reflects the child us being the children of God is we do not continue to sin. Yes, you are saved and you have been involved in sin. The question to you is, do you continue to sin with no regard, concern, or conviction of that sin? If so, then you need to be concerned. The other thing that this scripture in 1 John 3:7-10 talks to us about is the fact that we must love our brothers and sisters. Yes, that's another characteristic of being the son of God, the child of God, the daughter of God. Do you love your brothers and sisters? Do you love your brothers and sisters? And there is the last part where he said, anyone who does not do what is right is not God's child. So what do you do today? What are the things you do? You know, God speaking to the Israelites, says, see, I'm going to plant my covenant in the tablets of your heart. They don't longer need to tie it over our heads, because today we know what is good, we know what is bad, we know what is right, what is wrong. See, God says, I place before you two choices, life and death. He said, choose good, that your day may yet be long. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, he said, this book of the law, let it not depart from your mouth. He said, meditate upon them day and night, and observe to do. He said, that way you make your way prosperous, and you have a good success. God wants you to have a good success, but you need God at the center of your life to do this. And that's why Jesus today is knocking at the door of your heart. He wants you to be of the Father and of the world. So if you would open up and allow him coming to sup with you, will give your life a meaning and change the things that drives you in life. And that's why this morning we're asking you to call the numbers on the screen, so that we'll be praying for you, we'll be walking with you as Jesus leads the way. God bless you. Amen.